On April 17, 1837, in Hartford, Connecticut, a pioneer was born. A man who would advance the country of the United States and shape how it turned out today. His name was J.P. Morgan.
J.P. Morgan was one of the most powerful and influential businessmen who pioneered the banking industry and helped advance and grow the country with his business tactics. His leadership, determination, and personal drive for success were what differentiated Morgan from the most, and what made him possibly the most intelligent businessman of all time.
J.P. Morgan grew up in Hartford, Connecticut with his brother and three sisters, all of which were younger. He went to school at Cheshire Academy in Cheshire, Connecticut, a highly respected private school. It was there where J.P. Morgan showed great leadership qualities that impressed his father.
Throughout his childhood, J.P. Morgan faced many obstacles. He was often hospitalized for rheumatic fever, an illness that left him in so much pain that he could not walk. It was a big challenge he had to deal with at a young age, but his perseverance and tough mental strength were two traits that would remain prevalent throughout Morgan's life and contributed to his great success.
J.P. Morgan's father played a pivotal role in his life. His father, Junius Spencer Morgan, was a very successful businessman as well, who became extremely wealthy after the great success of his dry goods company in Hartford, Connecticut. He was able to provide a lot for his family, especially for his eldest son, Morgan. But perhaps the greatest gift he gave him was the gift of education and business intelligence.
He raised his son, Pierpont, with a great deal of love, but also a great deal of discipline. Junius Spencer Morgan expected that his son would follow in his footsteps and succeed in the business world.
In 1854, life changed dramatically for Morgan and his family when his father decided to partner with a London bank firm. His father made the executive decision to move the whole family to England to comply with his new business plans. This decision was indeed a smart one for Junius Morgan. He had become one of the wealthiest bankers of all time.
However, J.P. Morgan won standing in England as he attended college at Göttingen University, located in Germany, where he showed a great aptitude for mathematics. But after his first year in college, at the age of 20, J.P. Morgan's father arranged for him to sail back to New York City and work in a banking exchange. J.P. Morgan took the job and left his family completely behind.
J.P. Morgan was headed for new roads and new life. His tenacious and excellent attitude inspired many, including his partner-to-be, Anthony Drexel. He started his new firm, J.P. Morgan & Company.
J.P. Morgan applied the business tactics he learned at college and from his father. This paid dividends to the success of his new company. With hard work and perseverance, J.P. Morgan & Company has been propelled to the top of the banking industry.
Morgan was not simply just satisfied with his early success. He wanted more to advance the country technologically. He decided to invest his profits into young inventors with new cutting-edge ideas. One of the more commonly known inventors would be Thomas Edison, the man who created the light bulb.
Morgan saw a lot of raw potential in Edison, especially after his new, highly demanded product. But many don't know that Morgan actually provided Edison and his company with a tremendous amount of financial aid. Morgan bailed Edison out of bankruptcy on multiple occasions and even provided funding for Edison and his company.
In exchange for Morgan's generosity, Edison gave Morgan part of the company. So both of them profited when the company became extremely successful. This company was General Electric's, a company worth close to $260 billion today. It is also headquartered in Fairfield, Connecticut.
Although Morgan did profit greatly from Edison and General Electric, Morgan's main acquisition was the purchase of U.S. Steel. In 1901, Morgan bought U.S. Steel for $500 million from Andrew Carnegie. It became the largest enterprise ever created, and today, U.S. Steel is worth a little over $4 billion.
Due to the great success of J.P. Morgan's investments, purchases, and his own company, J.P. Morgan had become one of the wealthiest men in the entire world. This money gave Morgan great power and influence over most of the country. In fact, he was so powerful that the United States government turned to Morgan's bank for economic aid twice in 12 years. Once with the Depression of 1895, and the other being the economic crisis of 1907.
Although many Americans viewed Morgan as a national hero, he also attracted a lot of criticism and scrutiny. Many accused him of creating a monopoly and making it virtually impossible for any business to compete with his.
After his creation of U.S. Steel, he controlled somewhere between 60 and 70% of the American steel industry. He controlled a third of American railways at a time when railway stocks comprised 60% of all the stocks on the New York Stock Exchange. So the American public could be forgiven for imagining that Mr. J. Pierpont Morgan owned the United States.
In fact, J.P. Morgan's businesses had become so powerful and successful that the U.S. government tried to enforce laws from creating such dominance within a particular industry. However, this didn't really affect Morgan's businesses too much, as they were still profitable, just a little bit more restricted.
At this point in his life, Morgan had already achieved great economic and social accomplishments. His firm had practically conquered the banking industry, and both General Electric and U.S. Steel were both prospering. Morgan had attained all his career goals and became more successful than he ever imagined. It was time for him to settle down.
In 1861, Morgan married Amelia Sturgis. However, she developed a terrible tumor soon after their marriage and died the following year. But Morgan's perseverance showed once again, eager to find someone new. He then married Frances Louisa Tracy on May 31st, 1865. They had four children.
After Morgan married, he decided it was time for retirement. He moved his family to Europe, where he gained a great appreciation for art, and even started to collect himself. J.P. Morgan, a rough, stern man who was always pushing the limits and striving for greatness, was finally fulfilled. He knew what he had accomplished.
Morgan died in Rome, Italy on March 31, 1913, just shy of his 76th birthday. Flags on Wall Street flew at half-staff, and the stock market closed for 2 hours when his body passed through New York. His remains were interred at Cedar Hill Cemetery in his birthplace, Hartford, Connecticut.
The Pierpont Morgan Library opened to the public in 1924, stands as a beautiful monument to the awesome power that one man was able to amass in a way, Pierpont Morgan is our Napoleon. We're fascinated by a sense of control of his art. We're fascinated by his successes. We're even more fascinated by his failures.
At the time of his death, Morgan was estimated to be worth about $68 million himself. His business, J.P. Morgan Chase, which he left for his son, J.P. Morgan Jr., was worth over $2 billion. And lastly, his incredible art collection, which was later donated to the Metropolitan Museum of Art, was worth over $50 million. He truly was a remarkable man.
J.P. Morgan was perhaps the greatest banker the world has ever seen. He contributed so much to the country, both through his business tactics and through his involvement in companies like General Electric and U.S. Steel. But J.P. Morgan always put the country first. He embraced the American ideals of freedom of opportunity and having the ability to be as successful as you want to be. He was and still is a paragon for many Americans, and it all started on April 17th, 1837, in Hartford, Connecticut, when a pioneer was born.